live on the Genesis Communications Network. Thank you for tuning in. Welcome to Flow of Wisdom Radio. I am your host, Sean Anthony. We're live every Sunday, 3 to 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Looking forward to talking to you and with you. Call in, join the show, be a part of it, 877-300-7645. That's 877-300-7645. And my website is flowofwisdom.com. Log in, get connected with me, and definitely say what's up. Listen, lots of things continues to progress and move on, and it's just really amazing seeing the progression of things. For those that have been closely listening to the show and following the show week in and week out, you guys know that I've been pretty vocal and transparent on my television consumption. For going on close to a year now, I would say that me watching television has been dramatically reduced. I would say probably 95%. It might even be more than that. I don't know. I'm really just going off the top of my head. If I want to watch something, I'll watch something online. Can I let you guys in on my little guilty pleasure? When I like to unwind, Family Guy is my show. I like to watch episodes of Family Guy when I just don't want to think. I just want to laugh. You know, I love stand-up comedy and all of that good stuff. But anyway, with that being said, a couple of days ago, I ended up catching maybe about 20, 30 minutes of the playoff basketball game, the Cavaliers versus Boston, or whoever they're beating right now. The Celtics. It's the most recent game where LeBron and the Cavs, they blew them out by like 60-something points. And I didn't watch the entire game, but I was like, man, you know what? I don't have anything to do on my schedule this evening. I'm going to relax. I'm going to unwind and take a break from researching and reading and stuff. So I watched the game, like I said, about 20, 30 minutes or so. And wow, it was so amazing to me to be able to watch television and just see the programming so clear. It was so much more clarity. You know, it was just really, really different from before. I knew that it was, predictive programming and propaganda inside of the advertisements and things of that nature, but it was so clear to me. Every single commercial that came on, it was just very, very clear to me. And in fact, it was here I call myself taking a break from researching this stuff. I grabbed my notebook and my pen and I started jotting notes as I'm watching these commercials. And here's a couple of things that stood out to me, because after that, I shut it off and I was like, all right, it's done. LeBron is going to win anyway in the Cavs. But Intel, there was an Intel commercial. And I don't remember verbatim all of what's said. I just jotted down a couple of statements that was mentioned in the commercial that stood out to me. And one of them was in the Intel commercial, there was a line that said, "We know the future because we're building it. We know the future because we're building it." There was another commercial of IBM. An IBM commercial said, "We can do that," and it kept repeating after the human. This IBM commercial was very, very peculiar, very, very interesting, because I'm going off the top of my head, it was like a human being speaking to another human being, but the AI was monitoring the human being. It was person A was asking person B the question, and person B was like, "Yes, we can do that." And then the AI kept repeating what person B was saying, "Yes, we can do that." And that's, as soon as I seen it, I was like, that's machine learning, and they're showing it. So, and then there was another commercial, a NyQuil commercial. And one of the lines that stood out to me in that commercial was NyQuil, because sleep is good. Sleep is good. In that commercial, and I could be wrong, I do not remember anything that this NyQuil commercial was referencing any kind of cold symptoms or anything. It was more or less referencing go to sleep, stay asleep. You need sleep. Sleep is good. And I was just like, wow. And you wonder why, rhetorically, I'm asking myself, you wonder why so many people are, and I'm throwing up the air quotes, are asleep. How many people are not awoke? You know, you need to wake up. And I was like, man, this programming is just so effective. So as I'm reading that, oh, there was another commercial. Geico, it was a Geico commercial. And it was a husband and a wife. And something happened, got into an accident, or they got a flat tire. They're pulled over to the side of the road. And the husband's talking to the wife, and the wife is just all on her smartphone, swiping and swiping and pressing buttons and swiping and swiping. And the husband's talking to her, and she's not saying a word. And she's just all on her smartphone, right? And it shows you, you know, screenshots of her contacting Geico, letting them know her geographical location. And before you know it, tow truck comes out, fix the flat, and they're back on the road. And at the end of the commercial, it was nobody talk. Nobody talk. And basically, the Geico commercial was about, you know, using their app as opposed to calling and speaking to someone. And it's just, I was just like, wow, the programming, the propaganda, it is so there. And I see it so much more clear now because I've unplugged from all of that. Then fast forward, I was at an event last night, and one of my friends noticed this couple that he knew. Boyfriend and girlfriend, fiance and whatever, I think they were engaged, and they were sitting directly across from each other, facing each other, but they weren't even talking to each other. They were on their smartphones, right? So my friend, he's loud, he's boisterous, he's very funny. He comes over, he's like, hey, so you guys just texting each other back and forth? Is this how y'all do on date nights, you know? Hi, honey, how are you? Oh, I'm fine, LOL. And he's acting like he's texting while they're sitting face-to-face to one another. Where's the human interaction? No one wants to interact face-to-face that much anymore. We're becoming surrogates of technology, just like that old the movie I think Bruce Willis starred in, Surrogates. You get plugged in virtual reality. One of my students brings in the virtual reality thing by Samsung. You put your Samsung phone in front of the device, you put it over your head, and he's like, you know, here, Mr. Anthony, try it. I tried it. I mean, the thing is, it's amazing. It looks sweet. It's like you could walk around. And I was like, well, I need to sit down. Pull up. Somebody give me a chair. This is messing up my equilibrium here. But he was showing me the different games and how you can use. And you can look up and around and this whole virtual world. And it's consuming us. It is consuming us. So I'm watching 15, 20, 30 minutes or whatever the basketball and just monitoring these commercials. And I'm like, man, the propaganda and the programming is definitely in full effect. So it made me, it inspired me to go to the father of propaganda, if you will. As according, you know, especially here in the United States, and that's Edward Bernays. I pulled out his book entitled Propaganda, which was published in 1928. And there's certain excerpts I'm going to share with you in this particular chapter called The Psychology of Public Relations. You know, many people don't understand that we're being programmed. The suggestion, the power of auto-suggestion, I think it was Think and Grow Rich by Napoleon Hill. There's a chapter in auto-suggestion. Here's one thing I notice, even when I don't watch television, when I'm on the internet, researching, searching different things, or shopping or browsing, I'm still getting hit up with the programming, the marketing, the ads. That's frustrating. I'm looking for new shoes or something, and then all of these ads on the website link to the website that I was looking for a particular article of clothing or what have you. It shows up in my email. It shows up when I log on to this website. It shows like, ah, dog, man, ain't no privacy. No, it ain't no privacy. But we're going to go into propaganda. And the Internet of Things is definitely here in full swing. We're going to touch on 5G as we did last week. We're going to talk about mind control. And involving the Internet of Things, mind control. I told you last week as well, maybe a couple of weeks ago, Mark Zuckerberg, probably several weeks ago, Mark Zuckerberg confirms that Facebook is working on mind reading technology. DARPA, we're going to talk about DARPA, stating the fact that we're moving to merge humans and machines. If you don't think that we are about to be intertwined with machines and internet and high advanced technology, you got another thing coming. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. All right. Welcome back to Flow of Wisdom Radio. Thank you so much for joining me this Sunday. Of course, we're live every Sunday, 3 to 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. The toll-free number is 877-300-7645. Edward Bernays, he is the nephew of Sigmund Freud. And for those that don't know, I did a series last year on this man and the whole social engineering construct. In fact, you can go back and listen to that series. I think it's a four or five part series. It's entitled Social Engineering, the Manipulation on Human Behavior. Check it out. Please check it out, because it'll definitely give you some understanding on how predictive programming is set up, then propaganda is used in every aspect of our lives. Like I said, whether it's from television, whether it's driving down the street, on the billboards, you see it on the internet, when you're browsing and searching and looking up different things. And when you understand propaganda, you understand that, okay, we're definitely being programmed. So here's a couple of excerpts from this book entitled Propaganda, and by Edward Bernays. It's in chapter 4, The Psychology of Public Relations. And I'm going to skim through it. Like I said, I have a couple of excerpt parts highlighted, but I want to share it with you so that you can really get some understanding how far an advanced propaganda is now, because this book came out in 1928. It says, the systematic study of mass psychology revealed to students the potentialities of invisible government of society by manipulation of the motives which actuate man in the group. So the question naturally arose, if we understand the mechanism and motives of the group mind, it is not possible to control and regiment the masses according to our will without their knowing it. The recent practice of propaganda has proved that it is possible, at least up to a certain point and within certain limits. Mass psychology is as yet far from being an exact science, and the mysteries of human motivation are by no means all revealed. But at least theory and practice have combined with sufficient success to permit us to know that in certain cases we can affect some change in public opinion with a fair degree of accuracy by operating a certain mechanism, just as the motorist can regulate the speed of his car by manipulating the flow of gasoline. Propaganda is not a science in the laboratory sense, but it is also, I'm sorry, but it is no longer entirely the empirical affair that it was before the advent of the study of mass psychology. It is now scientific in the sense that it seeks to base its operations upon definite knowledge drawn from direct observation of the group mind and upon the application of principles which have been demonstrated to be consistent and relatively constant. Now, let me just pause for a moment right there. When I did that series last year on social engineering, the human manipulation, I'm sorry, the manipulation of human behavior, I've come to the conclusion that it's all based on psychology. It's a psychological battle that's going on, a psychological warfare for your suggestions to fall in line with their agenda. When I say there, it's vaguely used on those that want you to buy these large corporations and the people behind these large corporations and brands. They want you to fall in line with the things that they want to carry out. And one of it, because we're talking about technology and artificial intelligence and so forth, there's certain programming that is underway to get everyone to fall in line to begin to use the internet, their smartphones, devices for any and everything. This mind technology, we're gonna talk in, about that. This mind control technology is in the pipeline for the future. I know we spoke on 5G last week. That is very much near in the future as well. So much more, and AI is full swing. We'll be back. I come in the spirit of gratitude. I'm very grateful for the love and support that I get with Flow of Wisdom Radio. Thank you for joining me live here. I am your host, Sean Anthony. Flowofwisdom.com is my website. Big shouts out to the affiliates carrying Flow of Wisdom Radio. We're live on the West Coast on radio stations, guys. This is a radio show. This is a terrestrial radio show for those that may be listening after we are live. You know, you may be listening to it on the internet. This is not internet radio. This is not a podcast. This is a terrestrial syndicated radio show. Shouts out to KSZL in Barstow, California. That's 1230 a.m. Shouts out to 1110 AM. That's in Salem, New Hampshire. That's WCCM. I appreciate you guys, the newest affiliate. Shouts out to 89.3 FM in Chattanooga, Tennessee, WTYT. Also, another station in Tennessee, Knoxville to be exact, WBCR. That's 1470 AM. And also, shouts out to 100.9 FM in West Lebanon and Vermont. Vermont/New Hampshire, as well as Forks, Washington. That's Washington State, 96.7 FM. That's KBDB HD3 on that frequency, 96.7. So, and of course, 101 The Fam and Virginia, and all those that are listening across the country and even worldwide on GCNLive.com. The toll-free number is 877-300-7645. Send me a note, flowofwisdom.com. Leroy just wrote and asked me if I seen the commercial, the Watson commercial that state it is learning. Yes, I did, Leroy in Atlanta. That ties into some of the other commercials that I seen. Like I said, when I watched television for like 20 minutes the other day, they're letting you know they are gearing us up, the masses, for artificial intelligence to letting us know that, look, this is about to be a part of our daily lives. It was so much importance that, remember last year, I kept stressing that the White House put out a document talking about the preparations of artificial intelligence. Like, it's and now to see the advertising rolling out with IBM, Intel, and Geico, and all of these other big corporations, it's about to be a heavy floodgate of more of these things. So look, propaganda, as I said, is in full swing. It has always been in full swing. I'm referencing back again to the book Propaganda by Edward Bernays. In the chapter, The Psychology of Public Relations, there's a part in here that says, if you can influence the leaders, either with or without their conscious cooperation, you automatically influence the group which they sway. It says, but men do not need to be actually gathered together in a public meeting or in a street riot to be subject to the influences of mass psychology. Because a man is by nature gregarious, he feels himself to be a member of a herd. Even when he is alone in his room with the curtains drawn, his mind retains the patterns which have been stamped on it by the group of influences. So Edward Bernays is clearly saying, look, you don't even have to be in a herd or anything. You can influence the leaders either with their consent, their cooperation, or without it. You can automatically influence the group which they sway. His words. He says, in actual fact, his judgment is a melange of impressions stamped on his mind by outside influences which unconsciously control his thoughts. This man was brilliant. It was very brilliant. It could be, you could say, well, how can you call that, you know, if it's sinister, you know, you're controlling people, you're manipulating people. Well, I mean, however you look at it, you know, whether it's good or bad, it's ingenious because it's a very effective, it's effective what he does. It works. And if you haven't listened to that series I did, Edward Bernays is the reason why women began to smoke cigarettes during this time frame, and also he's the reason why what's called considered America's breakfast is eggs, bacon, and toast. He's the reason for that. When I ask people, I say, "What do you consider America's breakfast?" And most people say, "Bacon, eggs, sausage, pancakes, toast." But you're right. All of those things. It's because of the propaganda, the programming of Edward Bernays. Large corporations would hire Edward Bernays to get them to buy their product. This guy was some would say an evil genius, if you will. But I'm going to come back to that. We're going to set that down here for a moment because there was a survey conducted, the Internet of Things survey, ranking mind control as top technology in the year 2025. This is on insights.globalspec.com. And this was published just last month. Engineering 360 News Desk. The future technology of choice won't be new smartphones or laptops. It will be the human mind. Results from a global IEEE, world's largest professional organization dedicated to advancing technological innovation for the benefit of humanity. It was a survey, and they find that the human mind will be the technology of choice to control devices in everyday life in 2025. Mind control is coming. It's all up in your head is the subtitle of the image on this particular post. The survey results note a decline in the significance of cell phones and mobile devices as the primary means of controlling technology and highlight autonomous vehicles as the preferred mode of transportation. Now, let's set this down for one moment, and I'm going to break this down on how they're already pre-programming the masses to use this type of technology. You've already seen the videos floating around about RFID chips, people getting the little rice pieces. Looks like a piece of rice. It's an RFID chip in between the thumb and your index finger, right underneath the skin. And people can access things, buildings, without pulling out a card or anything like that. Then, you know, some companies now have iris scans where you just put your eye up and it scans your eye, and boom, you have access. The Fitbit watches, you know, the Fitbit watches they have, that you put them things around your wrist, and they say it's for to monitor your steps and to monitor your heart rate, to monitor this and monitor that. Now, those are the things that they tell you that they're monitoring, so you can stay fit. You know, for me personally, look, and there's no knock against anyone that uses it, so, you know, to each his own. But for me, I don't need to count my steps. That's just me. I'll digress, because I don't want nobody to feel bad like I'm shunning you if you use this or anything like that. Just go walk. Just go for a walk. Go for a jog. Get on the bike. Get on the elliptical. Whatever. Go lift weights. Go gym. Go to the gym. But it's conditioning people to keep this technology incorporated into their daily lives. Google had a big thing event just recently, and one of the things that they were talking about, the Google Lens. It's you know how they have the Google glasses, right? They're working on things to just sort of like a, what do you call it? A contact lens, so that you can see the Internet of Things through your eyes. And it's just so much stuff. The cloud and all of the interesting advanced technology that they are working on. So back to this article here, the Internet of Things survey ranks mind control as top technology. Let's see. Diogo Monica, who is the security lead at Docker, says, as technology evolves, it becomes more and more integrated with our daily lives and its physical presence shrinks. Consumer technology is advancing beyond the constraints of mobile devices to wearable form factors, and the next step in this evolution will be the ability to control technology in a hands-free way using brain power alone.
We have Lark.
All right. As a growing number of connected devices produce ongoing flows of data, security measures will need to keep pace to protect personal and corporate information as it travels over the Internet of Things network. So the article is clearly pointing out basically the example that I just gave, these wearable devices. That's how it's getting us prepared to putting down the smartphones and just having a digital device intertwined with our brain, our mind, and we can be able to control it, such as walking into a room and cutting on the lights without cutting on the lights, using some sort of mental telepathy or what have you. But it's really not. You're connected to this network. And that goes back to the show last week, where we talked about 5G and how powerful this is. This is going to change the speed of wireless connections. It's going to change the responsiveness. It's going to change the capacity and of holding data. It's going to change a whole lot of things with artificial intelligence, machine learning, and 5G network. We'll be right back after this message. This is Flow of Wisdom Radio. Have some interesting things to share with you that was let out recently at the big event that Google had, introducing all of its new components. Welcome back to Flow of Wisdom Radio Live. I am your host, Sean Anthony. Flowofwisdom.com is the website, and the toll-free number is 877-300-7645. TechCrunch put out an article, Everything Google Announced at its Google I.O. Keynote. a couple of things that I'm going to share with you guys. There are now 800 million monthly active users on Google Drive. 500 million Google Photos users who upload 1.2 billion photos every day. More impressive is that there are 2 billion people using an Android device today. And that's really interesting because it's almost 2 billion users on Facebook alone as well. Those are two major giants. We know that. Artificial intelligence, of course, was the big theme of the conference. The article says Google is going to apply a layer of artificial intelligence to all of its products. And it starts with Google Lens. Google Lens, guys, is this the new technology. It's pretty interesting because what it does is you'll take your phone. Well, they say it's going to make this technology is going to make your phone smarter. You'll be able to point the camera of your phone at something, and Google Lens will figure out what you are looking at. Say, for example, if you're hiking, okay, and you've got your Google phone, your Android, or what have you, and you got the Google Lens, and you don't know if something is poison ivy or not, or if a leaf is edible or something like that. Stay away from the mushrooms, guys. Anyway, you could point your the psilocybin, right? You could point your Google Lens at it, and it'd tell you exactly what it is. It's pretty cool. Also, Google.ai. They have launched this new initiative, and it's called Google.ai. And I'll admit, I'm personally excited about this because what this is a platform to share research papers, tools, and more with the rest of the AI community. And for research purposes, I think that is pretty cool. It's pretty awesome. So so much more. I just think that a level of preparation needs to be, you know, either you're going to get programmed, sucked into it and drawn through, or you're going to, you know, stand back afar and see how you're going to participate in this whole thing. Anyway, let's go to California. We have Lars out there. Lars, you attended the conference, man. Welcome to Flow of Wisdom Radio. How are you, Lars?
Hey, Sean. Doing really good, and great to be a citizen of the Kingdom of God.
All right.
I was at called the Internet of Things World Conference in Santa Clara last Thursday, and I went. Rick Wiles and his team was over there from True News, and there were some interesting things that I picked up. Number one thing, there was hundreds of vendors there. One of the vendors was Homeland Security.
No.
And they actually had a presentation. And they're actually giving money out up to $800,000 that you can receive within 10 days. And this money is going to be used for security of the Internet. So people that have ideas, and I encourage your listeners, if you got anybody that's got witty ideas from the Lord, go to Homeland Security and get some of their money and use it for the Kingdom of God.
Lars, hang on real quick, because I want to ask you some questions about that. But you're right. Hang on the line when we go into the second hour. That's listen. Let me tell you guys something. This artificial intelligence technology is so new. Like the I won't say it's so new, but the playing field is so wide open. Like Lars is saying, if you have some ideas to create new apps or anything like that, now is the time, because companies like he said, Homeland Security and so many others, are pouring out hundreds of millions of dollars to advance the technology. Stick around for hour two. We'll be right back. It's Flow of Wisdom Radio.